Look at that. We've got Astroneer. Check. We've got Metal. Momentarily. Check. Boom. All right, back to the Astroneer. Early access. That is correct. Today we're jumping back into the final early access build of Astroneer. Oh, we have Kika at the door. Pardon me, human. You're locking me out. Okay. She said, oh, am I not turdly enough for the turtle club? But she is. She is turdly enough. Alright. Let's get it going. I freaking love this game. Especially the older version. Alright. Boom. Super Shredder Mobile. Let's get us to Kika. Hello, little kitty. How are you today? Ugh. All right. What's up, little bud? How you doing? Wanna come say hi to the camera? Come on. Whoop-cha. Oh no, they no can see our face, kitty. Here, take a break. I'll fix it. This is what I do. This is why you keep a human around. Cute little kitty cat. All right, let's see where my face went. Aha. There I am. Okay, Kika, are you ready? You ready for your close-up, kitty? Oh, my little buddy. Come here. Hot job. It's okay. It's okay. You're safe. I promise this, you're safe. There you go, see? He's not so bad. She said, damn you, human, this is not what I want. Oh, sweet Kika. Go ahead. There you go. She must assume her throne. Why does this keep bugging on me? Intriguing. Aw, Kika wants to go back outside. But why? Why, kitty? Why do you abandon me in my time of... Nah, it's fine. You're good. Just hang out for a minute, okay? You'll be alright. Wow, again? What the fuck? That's stupid. This camera sucks. The ones. That's why I have more than one camera. You update your software, one of the cameras stops working. Then you update it again, the other camera stops working, but the other one works again. So you just have to keep going back and forth like an asshole. Now this camera is simply not amazing, but it should work better, I hope. Hooray, I have face. Much too big face. There we go. In fact, let's put us over here. Alright, so last time I played, it took me way too damn long to get off the really big, stupid, radiated planet. But we made it back. Made it back to Terra. Or whatever they changed the name to. Any power there. Pull on the inside. I guess that's something. I'm gonna lug clay around, but I suppose a singular chunk of iron's not, or aluminum's not so bad. Boom. Alright, sun's up, batteries will start charging. Let's see, where is home? I don't see my infinite beacon. Huh, interesting. Uh-oh, the rover's stuck. In this version of Astroneer, you cannot remove machines once you have placed them on things, the big machines. We love marbles. I like that name. There we go. Uh-oh. We still got one of the cars stuck in the ground. Which one is it? Nope, looks like they're all good. Do you get stuck on a piece of thing? No? I don't see the infinite beacon. Whoa. See that either. Not a huge prize, but no reason to ignore it. Now we're talking. Look at that. That's scrappable. Oh my god, is it doing the same thing? Wow. Why does it do that? Weird. Oh, now it works. Okay. Back on the road. So we found some toys. As in a whole little solar panel. Cute. Okay, step one, start with the little stuff. Why? Because it's faster. That way, while the big stuff's going, instead of standing around doing nothing, you're on the move. The current version, updated version of the game, has a shredder big enough for that. And yes, you can put it on your vehicle. Your rovers.
You can also package up rovers and everything that goes with them and put them on a spaceship and take them anywhere. The rockets. Bases. It's okay, we can follow the star line to get back home, but that doesn't mean it's gonna be easy. Alright, biome change. Pretty much the same kind of scrap we had before. Wind generator instead, so instead of a broken piece of solar panel, we got a broken fin. Turning, so there's no power loss. Oh, and the solar's going too. All right, now we're getting into some heavy, hilly terrain, which can be most perilous for a four-car rover train. I'm gonna take my time just a little bit, not just charge through at full speed, because I don't want the planet to break, as planets are wont to do in this game. Plus there could be big awful holes in the ground. Although I'm pretty good at digging out a rover train by now, because I'm not the best driver. By theme, I mean, there's nothing wrong with it. This doesn't fit. Alright. Good times, good times. Beast crawl. Watch out for crevices, cracks in the ground. But at the same time, you also have to look up to see if there's any crashed spaceships up in the hills. But if you get caught looking up too much, you fall into a ravine. Or just get jacked up on a rock and stuck. Or gas planted from deep underground. That's right, in this biome, they get right close to the surface for you. I don't see anything in the hills. I may not be getting close enough to them. You've noticed the draw distance in this game is not amazing, even when you have 32 gigs of RAM. Well, let's have a look-see, right, shall we? Yeah, it's not using more than 8. I wish this game would use more RAM to load stuff sooner. But the early access, well, the current version also has memory leak issues sometimes too. Not as bad, but the reports still come in often enough, I'm afraid. Often enough. Alright, we're getting pretty far off the star band here, which is fine, but I don't see anything out here. It's kind of desolate, kind of bleak, kind of empty, kind of synonymous with void. Let's go up on this mountain over here. Hey, there's something. Wind generator? Alright. We already have a good little bit of scrap going, but not as much as I want, right? Where is this one? Ah, there. I was like, where is it even depositing? Alright, let's give the back one a blade to chew on. And then we'll start feeding little stuff into the front one. I kind of feel like this car should be in the middle. There should be one position back. Like, I need to swap the two middle cars. Get the, yeah, I think that's a good idea. Easy peasy, too. Assuming I don't bottom out high center on rocks. Come on. Just go. Oh, come on now. Really? You're gonna stop me completely over a couple of stupid rocks? What? Are you shitting me? Come on, game. Quit messing with me here. I don't care about your stupid rocks. Alright, there we go. A great car swap. Boom. And then it all just falls right through the terrain, doesn't it? I'm not kidding. That's kind of what would happen next most of the time. Straighten it out. There we go. Oh, a little bit straighter now. Okay. Easier way to do that. Since apparently I forgot how to back up a trailer, even though I used to do it for a job. All the time. Boop, boop, boop. That should be perfect. Ooh, that's a little far. Nope, just barely. Alright. Oh yeah, and the beacons. You always have to turn those back on after you save and reload. Don't forget the car beacon, it's kind of important. There. Now I won't feel bad about putting other materials on this one. Runs out of power, you just release the mouse button to keep going. You don't have to turn it off or anything to get back to a normal reticle. Should probably get out of the hole. Gonna run out of juice soon, run out of oxygen. Alright, so we got a couple pieces of copper. This one we will make one of the bad versions. There's nowhere else to put it. This won't get full range of power, but these will. And I'm gonna bring them with me anyway, so I might as well put them in at least the most optimal position. Like so. Ooh. Those usually sit underground. Ah! No! Don't do it! Don't fall deep into caverns! It's okay, I can get out if I do. It's not hard. It usually just involves a little bit of this. Now, is there anything to research on here? No? Darn. Why it's kind of important to be able to. That was just to reduce the resistance a little bit more to make sure I could get enough momentum to pull out. And because I have the light on the front of my truck, I can still navigate. Slowly. Looks like it went the other way. Shit. So much for slowly. Alright, the easy way to do this is to get way back and just slowly cut a ramp down. That you're gonna need some distance to push away. You can't just dig a ramp straight down to where the nose of your rover is sitting, because it will just jam in. because it's still being pushed downward by the rest of the trailer, the rest of the rovers. Could just flatten it over, but that gets kind of wonky. It's easier to fill in the whole thing and then just kind of shape it as necessary. And remember, the rovers are kind of wide, so don't skip out on the tunnel width. All right, that might just have done it. We also have to get rid of that thing and hopefully not undermine it because it was stuck on that. And then we have to get a little bit of this, because remember what I was saying, the rover train's forcing it downward. So even if you cut the ramp right, it still makes life so much easier to build momentum if you just go ahead and do that. Now, you step back from your ramp, and you just keep making sure that it's wide enough. And fairly flat and level. Okay, yeah, let's just go ahead and hope for the best. Hope that's not a mistake. You don't have to make a full ravine either. You can just dig a tunnel. That should be perfect. I think we'll make this on the first try. Look at that. Beautiful. Don't explode, brain. I need you. We can grind these up too, or save them. I'll probably end up using them, and I'll be happy I didn't waste more copper. Maybe. Perhaps. You know, and also, these are resources that I can move back. In fact, I don't even want them in here. I want them there. And then we'll put the dirt canisters on here. But not all four of them. Gotta save one for my own use. And then the table. Oh, we got a leg. Just shoving it backwards. Oh wow, Nick getting a late start. Look at that. Good on ya. Okay. I don't know if that actually saved more time than it used, but oh yeah. This is what these are for. I think one box will do it. Easily. You probably won't find much to shred now that I think about it, because it's in the side of the mountain here. Sometimes you'll find a few pieces, sometimes you won't find any. But what's important is that you put down extra tethers to make sure that if you fall down in there, you're not totally screwed. Or if you jump down in there. Hey. Why won't it let me jump while I'm doing the thing? There we go. And the other side again. And that should be enough. There's really no pieces anywhere? Oh, that's a shame. Don't forget to clean up. Alright. So much for backing the shredder up. Just got a couple of materials here. Nothing special. Nothing to scrap. It's good to gather a few random resources here and there while you're out scrapping. Unless you just have, like, you know... sticky wheels. Unless you've just got 50, you know... You have a trade platform for every resource just preset waiting for a scrap to be put on it. Nothing wrong with doing that if you're that diehard of a scrapper, but... Most people, it would be a bit overkill, and it's just a good idea to pick up some spare mats while you're out. Although I'm not going to be picking up any clear quartz, maybe a little bit, but not much, because, oh wow, we're going to take a different approach here. First, I'm going to see if there's research over here. Anything else that might be useful. Which means there's probably a lot of scrap over here. Ooh, little fall damage there, huh? Hilarious. Okay, I don't have any smelted copper. Let's see if there's any in here. I like to have work lights, but I forgot to bring more work lights. I only have the front headlight, and I don't want to keep screwing with it. Okay. Yeah, we can leave the small metal plates behind. Not really worth searching for in the dark. Kind of a pain in the butt. I don't see any research sticking out of the ground anywhere, but again, it's dark, so hopefully we're not missing anything. But you know, another option too is putting a research station on here in place of one of the storages, or even if you want to take your time scrapping and you don't really think you need two shredders, it's valid. Good, the flattening tool can save you a lot of time, but it can also just make a mess of things, so be careful. Use with caution at your own discretion. Don't take my word for it. And for the love of God, if it does end up tunneling, cut the top out. If the walls are high enough that you're making a tunnel, don't leave it that way. You'll kick yourself. In fact, I'll go ahead and use that. We'll just dump most of the scrap down there. Doesn't look like this has a the full body attached to it. That's okay. That looks a little too steep. Sun finishes rising again. We'll get the rest of the. We'll get our full wide mod back on. Uh oh. Is that a storm coming? No? Just pink reflecting off of everything? Okay. Fair enough. Too tall. Nope, tunnel's too small. Doesn't have all the other pieces around it. So that. You don't have a wheel, huh? This and this take the longest, so they'll be the last things to get burned. This does take a while on its own, though. So let that go in the back while we feed stuff into this thing. Take as long as I thought. For the sake of convenience, go ahead and pop that there and that there for my wide mod. Yeah, a lot of that stuff's missing too. There's no ring or other parts to it. Oh, there's the ring. Look at that. Alright, we got a good bunch of scrap here. Let's see, it looks like those two are totally full. That one's full, so we got 3 medium storages worth. Won't take much longer to get more than that, but I don't think we really need to. I think I'm gonna follow the star band and get home. I'm still confused by the fact that I can't see the beacon, but maybe I have to get close to the base for it to reactivate the infinite beacon. What I used to call the cheater beacon. But then I don't think of it as cheating anymore. This is a fun toy you gotta be careful with. hydrazine. Zydrate comes in a blue glass vial. God, not that again. The hydrazine then. And once again, no research. Feel like maybe I should take it underground? I don't mind scrapping underground. It's fun. We are jammed up. Maybe it's not the glitch, maybe it's actually stuck on a rock somewhere. No? Just didn't get all the way around the back. Okay. When it gets stuck like that, then you get back in and try it again. If you only went to the one place that you missed the first time, there's a good chance that other places got stuck the second time. So, if you have to get back out to redo it, then you should just redo the whole thing. Wow. Oh, the storms are glitched. Oh, man. Valuable enough to get stuck in the trench for. I'm pretty disappointed I didn't find any research out here besides this orange brick thing, which is, I'm lucky if that's worth 1,000. It's probably worth like 600, maybe 400. But I didn't find anything else, so I figured I might as well grab it. I left 4 slots, and if I found more than that, I can always just shred my medium storages. I really don't like doing the ones that are up in the mountains. Really? I don't see a storm anywhere. Don't let him get stuck under the car. Once you get the first 2 through, you can usually build enough momentum not to worry about it. Usually. No base beacon yet. Oh yeah. Now we're moving. Ooh! Village of the Dam. Definitely have not been to this one yet. Solar panel. Wind generator. The door. Cool, we got a base door. Those are always valuable. Alright, so this time, I'm gonna take the stuff that takes longer, and I'm gonna burn it first, because I need time to dig everything up. Was something. What was that? Wow. No ring. Wow, there it is. Man, sometimes those things are deep underground. Ridiculous. The ring is a one space wide, even though it's kind of big. So it's those. Okay. Nothing super valuable. Whichever one's done first gets this. Whoop. Hey. 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 This is a big base. Oh, it's a double base. That is a lot of potential. Let's go ahead and snag some of the good stuff. Go ahead and throw some of this stuff on. Break it down. That's only worth a 600, I think. Might as well slap that on there. No working medium generators yet, but that's okay. Whoa. Why? We got some cool stuff laying around. Gosh, I need more shredders. There we go, we got the screen for the research station. Mention the legs and pieces. Nice. All very nice. There we go. Damn, so much scrap. So much. All right, we're gonna save that and that for on the way out. just won't end. And there's an aluminum deposit under us. What are the odds? Alright. I think that's everything. Or at least close enough. That was a lot of damn scrap. Woo! Alright, now I just need to find... Well, I don't see any. So... I always mark these things. So I'll just have to find some more quartz in a minute here. Oh, I missed one of the power cells. Well, you know what? That's okay. Because I'll burn that right now. Just let the batteries eat that right up, even though the sun's coming up. Don't care. Looks like we need to pull left. Oh look, there's quartz. We'll stop at the second one here. Generators up. Now we're definitely never going to run out of power. An extra 3 and 3. Oh yeah. Oh wow. These usually only appear near the base, but sometimes you'll find them pretty far away. And nobody knows why. Oh my god, no. Okay. Between these mountains? Okay. Could get a little sketchy, but we'll see what it looks like. Over here real quick and see if there's not any tech research. There is. Finally. 8,000. Good enough. I don't want to spend too much time scrapping. Gotta get home in time to use some of it, right? Alright, pop open some energy. Oh shit, sorry. I didn't even see you there, man. I had a screen in front of it. How's it going, fool, for fun? Oh, really? Uh-oh. I can't even hear the game audio. It's bugged for me or something. I don't know what the deal is. There's no filters. Space Subnautica is not the wrong way to look at it. You still with us? Can you hear me now? Ah, shit. Oh, no, maybe there's a road. If not, I'll dig one. Oh, we got a tunnel. I don't think I can drive up that, though. Let's see, where is the... Okay. How's that? Hello, Fool for Fun, are you there? Going that steep. All right. Now we're good to go. What is the deal here? Maybe it would be easier to drive over. It'd be easier to turn around. This mountain range is frickin' huge. Holy shit. Didn't want to admit it, but that's the truth. This could get ugly. Drive up that. Hope. It's gonna get messy. I have an idea. That should help. Okay. Yeah, that's still a bit loud, isn't it? Gonna be doing this much work. Really? It's sinking in the back, huh? Like, wow. Super glad I didn't clip through the wall there. The research stuff warps when it's windy. Too funny. The mountain. You can do it. Sleep in. So cute. The storm over. Big deal is for people, it's like 2 seconds. It goes by so fast. Why did they ever get rid of those? They claim people didn't like them, but then, like, I think they let it slip that they just didn't want to they couldn't get him to work in Terrain 2.0. So rather than putting effort into it, into maintaining the game's challenge, they decided to just go the opposite direction with everything and make the whole game way too easy. I laughed when they introduced creative mode, because I was like, what the heck is this? All you've done is save time, the game's not hard. The current version of it is just like ridiculously easy. Just time consuming, that's all it is. Come on. You can do it. Okay, no problem. This is why we have an oxygen tank and a battery, so we can do the big projects without having to run back and forth to our rover every 5 seconds. Whoops. And the music's gone. Because of course it is, why wouldn't it be? Oh my. Doesn't have to be perfect, it just has to be flat enough to be able to pull through. But you have to account for the length and change in the curve. So sometimes it can get pretty wide. Pretty wide of you. All right. I doubt that's going to be all I need to do, but hopefully it's close. Making roads on the way. Yeah. Now we're talking. Uh-oh. No. Of a beach. I kind of hear music playing. Now I'm not gonna be able to back up too easily. I could uncouple and try to maneuver around that way. But maybe I'll just back up as far as I can, see what it lets me get away with here. Oh, it's gonna work. Cool. Cool. I thought I might have to widen it more than that, but nope. We're good to go. Alright. And there's the star band going up instead of down, which is the way we were going, so I'm going the right way now. Full power. I wonder if I've already been to this one. Does not look like it. But I also don't see research. And those things are loud. Grabbing some of the ammonium, but not all of it, because it could be a dirt farm. There's an object way in the distance, which makes me think I'm in an area that I've at least been close to before. You see how close I am to a lot of this stuff when it spawns in. So if something spawned in way in the distance, it makes me think close to home. Or at least on the right path. That looks unfriendly. We'll go around this side. Hey, that's an intact medium solar. Boom, baby. And this is a bunch of mostly trash. Listen to the ones who complain. Ask all the people before you change. Oh. Looks like a tedious mess to get to. Of course, if I'm just gonna jump down in a ditch. easy bridge. Boom. Don't turn too soon or too hard, or you'll start losing your footing on it. Oh, and it is on the other side. Cool, I can cross that. Don't want no graphite. I'm on my way home. I'm gonna stop and do some scrapping first. Oh yeah. Damn the music. Louder. Louder music. Must have gems. We must have the gems. Oh, we're stuck. Mostly stuck. Not all stuck. No research. Moving on. Couldn't even see the materials in it. Don't care. This isn't gonna close up on me on the other side. Dig. Now we're going home. Home again. Off we go. There it is. Home ahoy. Very pitiful amounts of research. And a storm. Bring on the storm. really silly way to get out of this mess. Quite a bit wider than it needed to be, but it's all right. Nothing wrong with that. Base.
Burger. Egg.
Ugh. Come on. Not a very well terraformed base. Rover power is feeding into the base itself directly. Okay. Not bad, not bad. Let's go ahead. So much dirt we got left. Let's go ahead and cover this area real quick. Just to make it easier to use the rover around here. Not even worth it. All right, the rover. We lost power in one rover. I did anything else, I was supposed to grab my canisters. Thank you. dirt farm, dirt farm. Getting all the dirt farm done. Boom, baby. Alright, let's put those down. Whoops. Might as well. What are they pouring in here? Oh, that's not even plugged in. Good God. Ta-da! Okay. Oh, let's set the compound. We want... do that. This on. Let's see what over here now. Okay. And bring it out. Looks like I do need another What is it? Carbonate? Compound tungsten iron. Cool. Easy peasy. Have a pile of compound over here somewhere. There it is. Put that on top of this one. Make more batteries. Two lits. Who needs automation? The only thing automation does is allow you to build more automation. It's kind of boring. I don't need it. And there's not like a thing to do when, like, there's not a demand at the upper end for that much resource or productivity yet. Like, are they gonna do a paid DLC for? Just to have a point to this game. It's getting a little weird. Although we are starting to lose some power here. Still got a decent amount in reserve, but it's getting low. Looks like I'm gonna make some resin here. There we go. Order resin, I mean, not make it. Oh, right. You get 8 for 2. Or 8 for 4, I mean. I knew that. Alright, let's slap these two on. Since I just got so much scrap left to exchange, I guess I will build another table. But we also need some spalerite, which is also 2. We'll make it 8. Train back up. Have some research now. I can build these. Let's look around for anything else that might need. Nope, nothing there. Don't really build those much. These are handy, but we'll come back to that. Drop ship. This got replaced by the field shelter, which, I mean, okay. I don't use these much either. They're interesting, but overall, not efficient, in my opinion. 4,000 for that. Alright, but the important thing is that we added that, which is iron and resin. Oops. Yes, drop it off the edge. That's what I wanted. Clearly. Mm-hmm. any. I think that's all the scrap. I used up all the scrap. Awesome. That's what you want to do. Sense to leave the canisters off until I was done. Yeah. Looks like we took enough of a break for the batteries to recharge. You don't like the platform? Come on. It's a good platform, buddy. Sorry, buddy. Ceramic? No. Absolutely not. No ceramic. One scrap left in the whole base. Everything's smelted, everything's clean, everything's done. Now, what's really fun is these things, you can bury them in a hole to where they're at an angle, and then it makes the surface lay flat, so you can put, if you have like medium generators, medium solar especially, it's a good place for them.
Oh, hello, Kika. How you doing, buddy? You trying to sleep? She wants to sleep.
Okay. She wants me to turn off the lights. She probably wants me to shut the hell up too, but you know. Campfire style for the kitty. The storm is leaving. Oh yeah, I can make a turbo mod too. Now that I'm pretty well funded. The downside of the mods is that they occupy potential storage. I guess just for the hell of it, let's go ahead and do that. Let's get the hell out of here. Oh yeah. Oh, I almost forgot. Now I'm gonna pick up more raw materials because I'm getting a little low on certain things here. I don't even have any more copper. Ugh, crap. Well, I'll make one on the road. No. Where'd it go? What? Shit. Oh, there it is. Oh, I don't need to make another one. This one's sitting on the ground right there. There are 5 lights on this truck. 5 lights. Say it. Oh. I accidentally kept a little bit of scrap and an ammonia that I don't need. That's okay. I don't need that many extenders. I'm gonna grab some of the bigger stuff and get out of here. I'm not gonna do full shredding of all the sites. Just grab the big stuff and move on. Jump higher and run faster than not carrying something. You can just seem to dropping stuff to get out of a hole. It's not an accident. Outside to play and hunt. Although it's kind of dark, maybe she wouldn't. These shades in the new, in the current game anymore. Even exotic is just like three different shades of pink. They just don't have any flavor to them anymore. These planets had flavor and hostility. Challenge and fun. You know? Try down this way. What adventures and horrors await us on the other side of this tiny canyon?
Nothing. All clear.
There's nothing here. Nothing here at all. Hey, look at that. Copper out in the field. That's unusual as hell. Remember, we've got a turbo and a wide mod. To just feed right off the rover. Kind of want to go underground. It's pretty it gets pretty wacky down there. Aren't super valuable, but they're not. I think it's like 2,000. It's better than this, some of the stuff I was bringing back last time. Maybe 2,500. Oh, I didn't make a winch. Damn it. That's all right. There's more research. Just make your own little dumpling. Same difference, right? To cash out so much of my scrap for, well, for anything really. Just the basics that don't exist on this planet: iron, lithium, sphalerite, well, iron ore, and wolframite. Put these on the other side, organized. Wow, 16 resin. Neat. Is that really out of one pile? And then also, oh, I didn't leave my hydrazine behind either. When I go back, we'll make a rocket-powered rover. Should I get some compound? Couldn't hurt, I guess. Don't you want to go to the dark realm? Prizes and shit, bitches. Prizes and shit. That didn't quite go. Wow, both stacks were 16 even, huh? I guess that's fine. To mark this giant solar panel. These are another fun thing to bury and mess with and use, but but I need a winch to drag it back to the base, so I gotta leave it here. I don't see any research. Sometimes they do have research near them. You can see it's got a plug here. I'm not gonna dig it up quite yet, but you get the idea. Guys are junk. Well, I might as well take quartz with me now if I'm gonna keep finding stuff to put beacons next to. And if you ever put a beacon next to something and then you can't remember where it is still, get a shuttle, launch it into space, go find it. It won't take long. Just remember to reference it by the equator, based on the axis of the planet spinning. Wow, 2 hours and I haven't had any nicotine. Not even vape. That is unusual for me. What's even more unusual is now I've acknowledged it and I still kind of not reaching for it yet. Kill me. Hell yeah. Definitely feeling it a little bit of the craving, which is why I thought of it in the first place, but oh wow, it's a double header. There's a little bit of a gap there. Ooh, research. Utility tray. Nope, utility's full. Just shovel it there for the moment. Do not shred the other ash in your backpack. It's a container. You can't pick it up like that. Whatever. Let me go. I could shred those tethers. That is an 8,000. If I'm going to be looking for the aluminum ore, I might as well pick up aluminum pieces that I find. So almost another, maybe another 15,000 bytes of research loaded up on a little rover here. We're running out of power. quickly. Ah, we hit a breeze. Nope, it died again. Now we're out of power. Kind of stranded here. Till the sun comes up. These lights don't draw any power, but they have to be hooked up to power. They basically just don't use enough to notice. That's actually doing damage. Yeah, I was gonna say, where is that power going if it's not... At least till the sun comes back up. I'll just get in this one. Good time for a starburst. Just kidding, they're not paying me. Just be stupid. Although I can think of worse benefits for streaming than free candy. Yeah. Might use the last of my power up, but at least I'll get out of the storm. All right. Do a wee bit of organizing while we wait for a light breeze. Titanium, miscellaneous, organic. No, that's not, that goes with miscellaneous. This is going to be laterite. Alright, the lights are on, which means we're getting power. It looks like it's solar, which is going to take a minute to get all the way back to our... We can drive straight off the sunlight here. We won't move at full speed, but at least we'll move. shredding's done, so now the batteries are starting to fill up at a reasonably quick pace. Ooh, we got a little bit of wind there for a second. There we go. No? Let's just let him spin for a moment. Good enough. And behold the terror of stopping. What the hell is going on here? That's it, right? Alright. Sometimes when you have weird cave formations and ditches and stuff around the base of a mountain, there's a chance that you'll find Ashtoneer corpses. But not the kind that you normally find on the surface that have mostly junk in them. But, whoa. They'll be the underground variety that actually have some nice loot on them. Not really worth making a big deal of looking around for, but if you see one, you'll be glad you kept an eye out. Already been here. Should have realized that before I got out. Okay. Let's away! Another big resin pile. Is that what I'm gonna do? Am I gonna get more resin? Oh, it's gonna go fast too. Believe that. What? Well, I think 32 will be plenty for now. Don't need more compound. Nothing but this thing, huh? Just can't wait to have a new graphics card. Maybe the game will glitch less, I don't know. That's loud. I can hear them all the way across the room and then in the headphones. Jesus. What's the deal with that? Wow. We're actually almost full now. Not a lot of scrap, but still a lot of stuff we need. I guess when you fill up six storages with the most abundant resource in the game, the most abundant two resources in the game, I don't think one is actually more abundant than the other with between resin and compound, but maybe there's some difference, I don't know. I was grabbing the computer. Come on. One and two. Looks like I got to it already. But it could just be waiting to pop in. No, it's dug out. Alright. We're rolling. Come on. Rolling. What? Yep, been here before. Far out, man. Another one. That's two. Two of these supplies a lot of power. You build a few batteries and you're set for a while. A while. Quite a while. There we go. Oh, come on now. Oh, shit. Good enough, let's leave. Back to base with our almost 20, about 20,000 bytes. Turn. Not bad, not bad. And that is how you run scrap. Now, if you really want to get crazy with it, then, well, you just take a few generators on a big shuttle to another planet and start all over. One of the gnarliest places to do it is, well, I'd have to say Radiated, and actually they're all pretty tough. They're all pretty damn tough. But Exotic and Radiated are notably a pain in the ass. Like driving one medium rover around there is difficult to manage. No researchable, huh?
Damn.
Very disappointing. Gonna have to build a gas collector and fire it up really quick here.
Must have hydrazine.
Never let them tell you that the mods aren't helpful when you're scrapping. I don't know, maybe next time I'll... Wow, the camera froze again. What a piece of shit. It's okay, everybody. I'm upgrading. I'm gonna trade in my old FX stream box. It's... Apparently it's gonna die on me. So I'm gonna get a new Ryzen CPU for my primary so that I can use the 3600 for the stream box. And that should allow me to at least get 1080, 30fps, 720, 60fps, and some stability to it. Yay, Kika's still sleeping. She finally got some rest. Good for her. Okay. good time. No active wormhole. I always think of Stargate when I see those. It's so hard not to. All those tables. No! Damn it, I did it again. Nice.
Damn it, I changed again. One more time.
Oh, did I put those in the way?
No way. Oh my god, no way. Oh my god, no way. Well.
That extender should be right around here. I think that table's just sitting on it. Yeah. Oh, it's only 1,000. There must be a variation of it that's worth more. I can't just be wrong. There has to be a reason why I'm wrong. Of course, right? I mean, come on. I do not want the windmill. Lowered expectations. All right. Well, I guess there's nowhere to put that. All right. That's going to do it for me tonight. Didn't quite make it to 3 hours. Kind of a short stream, but we went from having a scrapper to use rover train to using a scrapper rover train. We'll build up the rest of our base next time. I'll get these tables distributed for storage and generation, and I'll probably going to have to flatten out the terrain in a pretty big area, but that's another thing the turbo and wide mod combo comes in handy for. So, until then, thanks for hanging out. Thanks for joining in.